Hello and welcome to Veggie Patch Ideas and welcome to the solar powered shed. Now, when it comes to installing solar on a shed and you're completely off grid, there are a couple of components you'll need, but it's really easy to set up and it just makes that nice little extra. So it all starts here with the small panel, and you don't need a lot to charge a battery. So this will do the job, and we just attached it nice and simply to the side of the shed that gets the most sunlight. Now, as you can see, this is a real easy setup. The wire comes from the panel outside, down this and into the nicely labelled panel terminal, and then there's another wire that comes out, and that's to battery, and that goes down here and onto two crocodile clips and straight onto your battery. So like I said, it couldn't be simpler. Just do it step by step as the book tells you. That is important. Now, this little black unit, it is dirt cheap, and I will link everything for you, what I used, if you want to follow along. You don't have to, there are others available, but these type of things, they're the most commonly used. And this is just a 12 volt system, so keep it simple and you won't go wrong. The more technical you go, the harder it gets and the more problems you run into. I've been doing solar on and off for quite a few years, and I've had loads of projects, but the simplest ones are always the best. So very simple, dirt cheap unit these are. The last one is load. If we want to direct wire a 12 volt load into here, so little LED lights. So if this was my garden at home, I would definitely put lights in here. And when I come out to the shed in the middle of winter, I need to find something, I'll just turn the lights on. Dead simple. As we're out in the allotment, I don't really garden at night. I may put them in. I might surprise you. You never know. But that's wiring it directly in there. You don't have to. There are two USBs, and these are simply, you can plug USB lights in, or we find our magic cable. And the reason I got this was just simply to charge my phone. I'd come up here, my phone would run out of battery because I'd be playing music or something, and then the missus would call me and I wouldn't get the call, and then I'd be in trouble. So I can now charge everything, which is good. So it's a simple case of USB, and that just goes straight into the slot, and we get our phone. And as you can see, there's power to this cable because I've got a little light on the end of it. And it simply goes in and starts charging. That's what I want. I can just keep it charged, no problems whatsoever, and everyone's happy. Even because, you know, the shed is your home away from home, you can plug a fan in. So if you want that fresh air moving around your shed, or if you're trying to dry seedlings out, or you have a load of seedlings in here and you just want that breeze over the top, which we know we need, I can use a little fan, and that makes the world of difference. So we've got our fan, we've got our phone, we can put a speaker in there. The world is our oyster, and it's all running off this simple little bit of kit. Now let's draw our attention to the battery, and as you can see, this is a solar collect. It's a special battery for solars. You do not need this. You don't need it. It complicates matters. It's a gel battery, and I bought this for a system I had running on my house, which was a complete off-grid system. I've now upgraded. I'm grid tied, so I'm straight to the grid in my house. I had the battery spare, But this had been sitting in my other shed for about, I'd say, 2 years, not being used. I've hooked it up today and I'm trying to give it some juice. It's struggling. I don't know if it's going to survive, but it is pulling load. So it's working to a certain extent and it's free to me because it wouldn't have been used otherwise. However, for your battery, don't go buying a new one. You don't need to do that. You can go either online marketplace or anything. Look for a car battery, just a normal car battery. Or if you're struggling on any scrap dealers, they're probably about £15 to £20. Pop it in and it'll run off a normal car battery. And that's the way I would go every day of the week for a shed. One more thing to note. When we're talking about batteries onto wooden shed floors, now this has a beautiful base on it, don't get me wrong, but the shed base is an OBS board, so it will bow if you put weight on it, and all sheds are the same. So I'll put a plank of wood and it goes over two rafters to spread the weight of a battery, because believe it or not, this battery is around 30 kilos. It's a heavy, big bad boy, and it'll just bow the bottom of a shed. And that means damp, because if the bottom touches the ground, it will get wet, and wet means wet wood, it's game over. So put it on a plank, spread the weight, and everything is good to go. Now, just to answer any questions you may have, this unit, I put it in this tin box just in case there's an electrical fire. You never know. So it's a tiny unit and it won't catch that much flame, so this tin will just collect and hopefully it'll save the day. However, I've used loads of these and I've never had a problem. The only other thing you need to know about is when there's no sun or clouds, it'll still pull some power into your battery. And once your battery is charged, it's fine, it's done deal, and then you can run your electrics straight from your battery, even on a cloud day, to charge your phone. Because you're getting all that 12 volt power off your battery. And basically, the solar just tops it up. At night, the whole thing will go dormant. It won't be running. And only the load, only when you plug it in to start using the load, this will then fire back up and use the battery. It's silent, you don't hear it. When you mount it onto the back of the tin, if you are doing it this way, give yourself an air gap, and that simply allows the unit to cool. Imagine if you're putting a lot of load through it constantly, the back of the unit will get hot, so we want to cool it down. So I've just put it on this bit of wood, and it sticks out about an inch from the tin. Airflow is the one you want, because airflow cools things, and especially in a hot shed, which is south facing. And yes, always put your panel facing the sun. I know it sounds silly, but the sunnier the better, and every day you're a winner. I hope you've enjoyed my solar shed.